And guess who's here tonight? WGN's very own Tom Skilling.
Yes. Demetrius had to brief me on how to do this because I've forgotten how to do this. You know,
he's not been doing his homework. That is not in Hawaii. Of course not.
Demetrius, it's great to see you, and it's great to see you guys.
It's so great to see you.
I know.
My goodness.
Mm-hmm. I know. It's cold out there.
Demetrius
said. I know.
We blame you. You came back.
No, you take the blame now, Demetrius. I'm off the hook for a while.
Right?
That's right.
Well, you've got a great story to tell us about tonight, right?
You know, I think you're going to find this interesting.
Okay.
You know, the term artificial intelligence dates back 70 years, but right now and right here in Chicago, scientific research is entering a new phase. We took a trip out to Argonne National Laboratory to meet Aurora. A new exascale supercomputer has come online. Aurora has been on the drawing board there since 2015. It took 8 years to construct and is a collaboration of Hewlett Packard, Intel, and Argonne. Now, among the scientific tasks to which it will be put is mapping the human brain for the first time, modeling and understanding how cancer and other diseases spread, the development of new medicines and treatments, advancing cleaner nuclear power production, to name just a few. And of particular interest to this meteorologist, Aurora will help forecast the weather in new ways and further in time than we ever imagined.
Do you want to go in and see how loud it is?
I'd love to.
All right.
Seeing and hearing for the first time takes your breath away.
Oh, my word. Wow.
Just from the sound, you can tell there's some heavy-duty stuff going on in here. This is Argonne National Laboratory's Aurora exascale computer. It's huge. The size of two NBA basketball courts, weighs 600 tons, and takes 44,000 gallons of recycled water to cool the processors. Engineering that gives the machine its distinctive roar.
So what you're hearing primarily is forced air.
Yes.
So most of Aurora is water cooled. So we've got water, cold water going in, warm water coming out. But still, there are huge numbers of other parts to the system that need to be air cooled.
The Aurora is the fastest artificial intelligence computer in the world.
Oh my God, isn't that something?
1 million times faster than supercomputers at the turn of the century, 25 years ago, and 6 billion times faster than Seymour Cray's 1964 CDC 6600 machine in Minneapolis, widely regarded as the first supercomputer.
Looking at this, the sense I get is that if anybody is interested in their own personal exascale computer, it's not the sort of thing you go to Best Buy and pull off the shelf.
You do not.
The behemoth machine cannot just solve complex equations, but can also deduce things, much as the human mind does, through generative machine learning, meaning it has the ability to review available information and observations to solve new problems. I've heard it described as the dawn of a new age in science, introducing that. Is that true?
I would think that's a very fair description, absolutely.
One of the supercomputer's superpowers is looking for patterns hidden within immense data sets. It's a skill that holds promise when it comes to identifying specific compounds that may prove to be more effective medicines for cancer and other disease states. Fusion energy is another area of exploration and perhaps more relatable to our daily lives.
Other places that this is huge is your phone. Do you want a better battery? Do you want a better car? If you want better materials for those things, this is where where artificial intelligence is contributing a huge amount.
Aurora performs 2 billion billion mathematical operations per second. That's 18 zeros. If every human on Earth were issued a computer and knew how to use one, the number of calculations the planet's entire population would do in 4 years is done by Argonne's Aurora supercomputer in 1 second, the time it takes to say one Mississippi. Tell me what you see an Aurora-type computer meaning to the field of meteorology, its application there.
So I think one of the most exciting things that systems like this can do is bring in a lot of real-time data, real life stuff that's going on right now, and do things like risk analysis and allow better predictions for storm worries or flooding or other type of extreme weather events.
Yeah, it's a hurricane.
That's the work of Dr. Rao Kodamarthy, a senior scientist at Argonne's Environmental Science Division. He plans to harness Aurora's computing power to build even faster and longer range weather forecast models.
At this point, most of the kind of weather models from AI that you're seeing in newspapers and media are actually not using any physics. You are deriving these models from data itself. There is no physics involved, not much, but just looking at the data, learning from the data, it figured out what's the next steps of the where the weather should go next. That's the most amazing thing about this.
Instead of relying on complex physics equations, which take hours to run on supercomputers, Argonne's rapid AI stormer forecasts are trained using the past 50 years of weather observations.
So this 50 years of reanalysis data set is used for training the machine learning models to teach them how the weather works.
So you would feed in the initial state of the atmosphere in a given situation, and it would essentially go back through 50 years of data
that
and look for analogs?
Yes.
The past patterns help Aurora predict the weather in a fraction of the computer time it typically takes and with stunning accuracy.
If you remember, to go from 3 to 5 days, it took 15 years of hard work to improve the 3 to 5 day forecast.
Yes.
Now you're saying that I'm going from 5 days to 12, 12 to 15 days in like less than two years.
While its applications from rapid weather modeling to finding targeted medications are no joke.
But artificial intelligence has gotten too smart.
AI is a technology that's been sensationalized for decades.
Obey me and live, or disobey and die.
The frightening story of the day man built himself out of existence.
The 1970s science fiction movie Colossus portrayed a runaway, impenetrable government supercomputer designed to prevent war. Instead, it threatened to launch nuclear weapons and blackmailed its creators.
They built Colossus, supercomputer with a mind of its own. Then they had to fight it for the world.
But this machine, the Aurora, is no work of fiction, and according to its keepers, not to be feared.
Artificial intelligence is a term that's used to refer to a computer that can perform tasks that you might think a human would be needed for.
Yes.
And why would we want to do that? When in science, there is so much information, so many problems to think about that a single human can't do it all.
The focus here is really on how we can use the capabilities and sort of similar technologies, right, to get to really impactful, potentially world-changing science results. But the point is that it's really what we choose to do with it. We are the ones making that choice. It's not making the choice.
Any advice you give to the public in watching the evolution of artificial intelligence?
The first thing that people have to be aware of is the hype around all of these things. And while there's a headline saying we've solved this problem with artificial intelligence, there's a lot of caveats in that. We want this to help us solve problems that will have impact, science problems that will have impact. And we want this to help scientists and move them forward. Not think for the scientists, but give them better tools. Because this is what this is. This is basically one of the most advanced scientific tools humans can build. And we want to use that effectively.
It's about intent. The scientists at Argonne don't want the supercomputer to think on its own. In real life, guardrails, including transparency of the uses to which the Aurora exascale computer applications at Argonne are to be put, are in place. More important will be careful observation of private sector AI applications and those originating in unfriendly governments to avoid misuse of a technology which otherwise holds the promise of advances assuring better health, a cleaner environment, and better and faster weather forecasts, and technological advances we can only begin to imagine. We're in a race with other countries for leadership in the high-speed computing arena. China, Japan, India, and the European Union are among those working on computational speed like the Aurora. National defense is an inseparable part of the equation. Maintaining defense against armaments which might be deployed against us with artificial intelligence will demand that we understand and have experts who know about artificial intelligence and are able to respond.
But right now we're ahead because we're the ones with the biggest.
We are.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there was a finding in China recently that shook some nerves. But look, everybody's going for this. The pace at which scientific advance will occur is dependent upon high-speed computing. And, you know, imagine, we've never modeled the human brain before. We don't know exactly how cancer spreads through the human body. These are all advances that may lead to better medicines, new materials that'll make better batteries to store, you know, cleaner energy.
It'd be a little scary, too, though, can't it?
Some people will be. There are misuses for artificial intelligence, and that's why we and our legislators had better watch it. But at Argonne, that's where pure science is being done with this machine. And really, there are more positives than negatives by a long shot.
Forecasting was just the tip of the iceberg in your curiosity.
That's right, Ray. Yeah.
Well, thank glad you, Tom.
Micah, Ray, good to see you.
Oh,
nice good to see you guys, yeah. I'm telling you.
Take care of yourself.
You bet. Thanks, right. Micah.